Coming up on this edition of Sports Zone, we have highlights of both down-to-the-wire basketball games from this weekend.
We'll be live at UD for the latest on tonight's game.
There's no doubt we want to be an Iowa Conference champion. You know, we want to go to the playoffs.
We sit down with the newest head coach on campus.
All this and more only on Sports Zone.
Welcome to this all-new episode of Sports Zone. Alongside my partner Nina Mack, I'm Zach Offlish.
There's been a lot going on in the sports world as we begin the new semester. Let's tip this show off with some basketball.
Well, it was a Duhok doubleheader against Wartburg on Saturday. The women looking to remain undefeated in conference play, while the men were looking to end their three-game losing streak. Let's start off the men. Tyler Jacobsmeyer hits an early three for the Knights, his first of 22 points on the day. Let's fast forward 3 minutes left in the first half when Aaron Schuler hits a three, putting the Duhawks up by eight. Then Luke Berry hits a three of his own to increase the Duhawks' lead to 11. 5 minutes into the second half, Jacobsmeyer scores this layup to put the Knights up 47-44. With 7 minutes left, Shula chalks up another three to cut the Duhawk deficit to one. Then a minute later, you had Shula again striking magic. 15 points in the day for him. And with 1:40 left in the clock, Eddie Deemer tallies this layup. Knights up 79-74. Despite a loose ball with 4 seconds left, Knights take this one 85-80.
Definitely tough. I mean, but we just got to look at it and learn from it and hopefully get some momentum going into the tournament.
Now on to the women. The Duhawk women start off slow, shooting 31% from the field in the first half. Q freshman Kathleen Cabrera, who makes this three, then steals the ball back for an easy layup to give the Duhawks a 28-26 halftime lead. The game stays close in the second half, down to the wire when Wartburg guard Bobby Burrows misses this last second shot, and we go to overtime. With the Duhawks down two with seconds remaining, it's Cabrera again with a three to give the Duhawks 66-65.
It's racing. I think we held our breath for a while, but it's good to win a game like that where we don't play our best. And good to be tested like that because we haven't been pushed against the wall in a while, so good for our team to experience.
What a great game and a great win for the Duhawks. Tonight, the women look to keep on building that momentum over at the University of Dubuque.
That's where we find our very own Sports Zone reporter, Allie Coletta. Allie, how's the game looking over there so far?
Thanks, guys. I'm here. We have 14 minutes left in the second half, and the Duhawks are leading 35-31. It's been a really close game, and it's been neck and neck the whole time. The Duhawks finally just pulled it out to start winning. Katie Langmeyer is really doing a great job down in the paint. She's putting up a lot of points. She's had 9 points so far. And Kat Cabrera is playing great defense for the Duhawks right now. So we're going to stick around, see how the rest of this game goes, and hopefully we can pull out a win for the Duhawks.
Thanks, Allie. We'll have to hang on and see if the women can get win number 16 on the year.
Absolutely. Hopefully we will. One of the most powerful weapons in the women's basketball arsenal is a senior forward from just across the river in Cuba City, Wisconsin. This week, Billy Rayfield shines the Duhawk spotlight on Katie Langmeyer.
Senior women's basketball player Katie Langmeyer has loved basketball since she was young.
I just love the atmosphere of the game and like the physicality of it all. My older sister played a little bit and she helped me a lot. And as I got older, the love for the game just grew.
Langmeyer has led the Duhawks to an undefeated conference record so far, but hopes the best is yet to come.
Everyone's goal is obviously conference championship, which we're sitting really nice right now. We have a few games left, so hopefully that can be one of our goals to reach. And then obviously making the NCAA tournament is a huge goal.
She also has some goals of her own.
I want to be like one of the better players in the league, and that's always a goal for myself, is just to be the best that I can be.
Being a senior, Katie has been through a lot of great moments on the court, but what has been her favorite?
Well, I'm hoping that it's still coming, but out of the rest of the 4 years, I'd have to say beating Carthage last year just because they were ranked. So that was like a huge win for us as a team.
Katie spends most of her time on the court, but when she's off the court, she makes sure to spend it with her family and friends.
Whether that be watching movies or doing other stuff, no matter what we're doing, it's just fun for me to be with my family and friends. They mean a lot to me, and I think it's important to have time with them outside of all the other activities that I do.
Reporting for Sports Zone, I'm Billy Rayfield.
Well, it was a wonderful weekend for the Duhawk track and field team at Illinois Wesleyan. The women made the Duhawks proud by claiming fourth place out of 14 schools. Morgan Steer had a great day, notching second place in both the shot put and weight throw as teammate Maggie Sines reached the finish line second in the 5,000-meter run. For the men, Josh Gert took first place in the 200-meter dash as Jordan Burkholder came in second in weight throw to lead the men to a third-place finish out of 11 schools.
The DuHawk baseball team escaped this Midwest winter weather over J-term, flocking to the Dominican Republic to play some ball and do some service. After landing in the Dominican Republic, the team went straight to the field and got to work. The DuHawks played four games against Dominican's Army, Navy, Air Force, and police teams. But the trip wasn't only for baseball. The team also helped children in need.
For the service project, we went to an orphanage where they had kids from Haiti and from the Dominican Republic. They weren't unwanted kids, they were just kids that the parents couldn't support. So we interacted with them, we had a lot of one-on-one time with them, we played sports, we hung out.
Well, you probably recall a major change into the football coaching lineup at the end of last season. With three games left, Coach Merkowitz resigned and offensive coordinator Steve Helminiak was named interim head coach. Now, his title is a little different.
How does it feel when I say that you're the 27th head coach at Loras College, at your alma mater?
Awesome. It's great. You know, bittersweet in the way it happened, but also feels great because, the love that I have for Loras College. I think it's a special place, and to be the head football coach, I think there's great responsibility. It's very humbling and exciting.
Do you guys feel, as a coaching staff and as a team, any pressure at all to come out next year and do a lot better as you did this year and keep on progressing each and every year?
Well, I don't know if there's pressure. I think there's expectations. There's no doubt we want to be an Iowa Conference champion. You know, we want to go to the playoffs, and we want to become a leader in our athletic department as opposed to being the anchor. If you do things the right way and you take things day by day, step by step, and you begin to build a program, the wins and will take care of themselves. And yes, we want to win. You know, we want to be the best team in the Iowa Conference. You know, I look up and down our schedule, and right now everybody looks at Loras as a W. You know, they circle Loras and say that's a W on our schedule, and that grinds at me every day. And I think it grinds at our players right now. And we want to turn that around and get that respect back to the Loras football program. I think we're going to be a drastically different football team, and it's going to be a lot of fun, and we're going to bring back that winning culture.
To see more of my interview with Coach Helminiak, head to myduhawk.com after the show.
After a rare Friday night off, the Fighting Saints welcomed their rival Waterloo Blackhawks to Dubuque. The Ice Center was rocking early, just 34 seconds into the game. The Saints' offense explodes when Phil Boyd blasts a slap shot past Waterloo goalie Cal Peterson. Early in the second period, Liam Pecoraro backhands the puck into the net to tie the game at one. Shane Iserman gives the Saints the lead late in the second when he lays out to knock the loose puck over the goal line. Then, with just 4.5 seconds left in the third, Waterloo pulls their goalie and Blake Wynicke flicks the puck in to tie the game. With 9 seconds remaining overtime, Carson Kuhlman scores for the Saints, ending Waterloo's 16-game win streak.
It's tough when they score in under 5 seconds there at the end, but I knew that we had it in us the whole way.
Despite the excitement Saturday night, the Saints would lose at Green Bay 7-2 on Sunday.
Well, now it's your time to score some free wings at our Buffalo Wild Wings trivia question.
If you paid attention during the DuHawk spotlight, you should know the answer. What is Katie Langmeyer's favorite moment as a DuHawk basketball player? Is it A, the win last year versus Carthage? Is it B, the overtime win this year versus Wartburg? Or is it C, last year's Iowa Conference tournament win against Coe?
Well, send your guess to lztv@loras.edu and we'll reveal the winner later in the show.
Coming up after this timeout, we'll see how the wrestlers did against St. John's University and Wisconsin Platteville.
And speaking of those wrestlers, we'll have one of them join us live in the studio, so stick around to see who it is.
It's a party in the USA.
Yeah! It's a party.
You're crazy.
I guess it can wait.
I
find inspiration all around me, from those that push me to think and to grow, to move forward, because to stand still is to fall behind. That's not my plan. I'm just getting started. Now, just watch where I'll go. Loras College. Affordable, challenging, life-changing.
After a win against UD on Friday, the wrestling team was excited heading into their dual meet against St. John's University and the University of Wisconsin-Platteville. Sunday was senior day at the AWC, and the seniors stepped up in a big way. Senior Cody Flynn gets a hold of Ryan Michaelis in the 197 weight class, takes him down and gets the win. James Buss pins his man in the 285 weight class to lead Loras to a 25-14 victory. On to UWP, where senior Matt Holmes takes down Mason Bohm in the 141 weight class. Senior Joe Wood claims his second victory on the day in the 149 weight class. Buss finishes it off for the Dewhawks, winning by a tech fall to give the Loras a 36-3 W over the Pioneers.
Gotta take everything our coaches say, just bring it in, take it 100%, work on it, go a little bit after practice, come in a little bit before practice.
The Dewhawks will take on Luther College on Friday with the winner clinching third place in the Iowa Conference. Tonight, junior wrestler Stephen DeWitt joins us here in the studio. Stephen, thank you very much for coming to SportsZone.
It's a pleasure.
All right, I'm gonna ask you a few questions if that's okay.
Shoot.
All right, how are you and the rest of the team feeling after picking up three crucial wins this past weekend?
We feel it's been a pivotal turning point in our season due to the simple fact that we've taken our lumps and bruises earlier in the year. You know, we didn't have people in the lineup. And now we've come back and we've gotten some solid wins in the NCAA. So I feel this is our time now.
Definitely. Definitely got the ball rolling for you guys, huh?
Momentum.
Absolutely. Was wrestling always your favorite sport growing up, or were you involved in other sports?
No, I wasn't in any other sports, but I was just a little fat kid. My buddy's friend's dad got me into wrestling, and here I am now.
So you loved it ever since, right?
Oh, well, love-hate.
Love-hate relationship. All right. What has been one of your favorite memories this past season?
Besides winning, there's so many. I think I would have to go with making my friends throughout the season would have to be my best memory.
So they help bring you into Loras, kind of?
That brotherhood you create with your teammates is the best.
Absolutely. That's a great thing to have. So how are you preparing for the Iowa Conference Championships this next weekend?
Well, we're not training like exact madmen at the exact moment, but we're starting to taper down. We're just kind of easing into it and getting our weight down just so we can be ready and knock them off just like we did with St. John's.
Let's hope that happens. What are you going to miss most about your senior teammates this year?
You know, I'm a transfer, so I didn't know them very long, but they're still my brothers due to the simple fact I've experienced this season with them. Mm-hmm. I think I'm just going to miss having them around next year, you know, roll
Absolutely.
Around and hang out afterwards.
So are you going to talk to them still after they leave and everything?
Oh, of course.
Wonderful. What is the biggest thing you've taken away from being on the team at Loras College?
Besides Dewhawk pride, I guess I would have to go with just breaking people when I'm on the mat. I'm not a very violent person off the mat, but when I am on there, I believe Coach Stu has taught me how to completely dominate.
Oh yeah, so you kind of have those two different personalities to take away.
Right.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much for joining us tonight on SportsZone, and good luck this Friday against Luther.
Thank you very much.
All right. There has been an exciting buzz on campus about a new sports team coming to Loras, and I have the scoop, actually, so let's check it out. This gym has been packed with students supporting Loras College athletics, such as men's and women's basketball, women's volleyball, and wrestling. Just recently, an exciting announcement has been made that a new sport is about to hit the court, men's volleyball.
It all started when an eager freshman and his roommate missed the intramural sign-up.
We had missed the deadline for intramural volleyball, and so we're thinking, like, what if we could just start a team? And so Jenna emailed us, and then we just emailed back and forth, finally had a meeting with her. She talked to student government. They said that it was a great idea.
After talking to Coach Jenna Ness and Athletic Director Bob Quinn, the recruitment for players began.
It's amazing when you make an announcement like this, all of a sudden you get students that are interested in Loras and that are interested in playing volleyball at the collegiate level, and we certainly have had that. So the admissions department and the athletic department are working to continue to recruit.
In addition to players, a search for a new head coach was also in motion.
We've started and moved forward with regards to the search for our first head men's volleyball coach. So we're moving forward with that right now. Process going very well.
Recruitment for a new coach and players created a huge buzz around the campus, and when asked what Neil's most excited about, he had this to say.
Just seeing where we are, because we've improved so much from our first practice till yesterday, and so to see how we do in an actual like game setting is going to be really interesting. I'm excited for that.
The new men's volleyball team will be starting up their season next spring.
Can't wait for that. Well, after the break, Nina and I compete in the first sports challenge of the semester.
You'll never guess what happens. Seriously, you will never guess, so do not go anywhere.
I'm on mydohawk.com.
I'm on mydohawk.
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 I'm on mydohawk.com. Are you?
Mydohawk.com. Delivering you Dubuque.
Welcome back to our favorite part of the show, the Sports Challenge. And this week, it was a crazy one at that.
I'm so excited to watch this, so let's get it rolling.
Hello, welcome to our first sports challenge of the semester. Today we're competing in basketball.
We're here with seniors Alex Klein and Katie Wheeler.
First, they will be shooting free throw shots.
Then they'll move back to the three-pointer.
And last, half-court shots.
So let's get right to it.
Nina won free throws, now onto three-pointers.
After dominating the three-point shot, Zach tied it all up with Nina at 1-1. Now we're on to the half-court shot.
All right, well, it looks like I won the very first sports challenge of the semester with a backwards half-court shot. Now, what is Zach's punishment for losing?
Should we make him do an 8-30?
Yeah, an 8-30 sounds good. He's got to run sideline to sideline 8 times in 30 seconds.
All right, Zach, let's see this get done. So, Zach, how do you feel about that last shot of mine?
I think that was all luck, to be honest.
You know what? I don't think it was luck. I think we should replay it again just to see it.
Oh, really? We really? Oh.
Slow motion. Oh, yeah. Look at that.
That's got to be luck. There's no way you can make that.
That is so not luck. That is pure talent, obviously.
Let's just say I haven't slept since you've made that shot. Okay, well, now let's give someone else to celebrate about. Let's reveal the winner of the free Buffalo Wild Wings.
But first, let's recap the question. What is Katie Langmeyer's favorite moment as a DuHawk basketball player? Is it A, the win last year versus Carthage? Is it B, the overtime win this year versus Wartburg? Or is it C, last year's Iowa Conference Tournament win against Co?
Well, the correct answer is A, the win over Carthage last year. And that makes Shane Williams our lucky winner. Congratulations, Shane.
Thanks to everyone who emailed, and good luck next episode.
Well, new this semester, we have a new segment called SportsZONE Do Play of the Week, where we highlight a top play in Loras Athletics. And this week, it comes from the DuHawks women's basketball game against Wartburg.
With Loras trailing by two, with 9 seconds left in overtime, Lauren Burns swings the ball to Kathleen Cabrera. Sound off!
Trying to find the open shot. Cabrera, the three-pointer. Go! Kathleen Cabrera makes the biggest three-pointer of her Loras College career.
You can tell I'm a little excited. Cabrera's three will help extend Loras' win streak to 10 consecutive games. Now help us pick our next Duke play of the week. If you're at a game, tweet us your favorite play at @LCTV_SportsZone and use the hashtag DuPlay. Then tune into SportsZone to see if your pick makes it on the air.
Thanks for joining us tonight. LCTV News is on next Wednesday at 7 p.m.
In the meantime, visit mydohawk.com and follow us on Twitter @LCTV_SportsZone for extended Loras and Tri-State sports coverage.
Catch us in 2 weeks for more of the latest and greatest in DuHawk athletics.